The gang struck at the luxury home of wealthy businessman Victor Lancaster. This man called posing as a workman, but a maid at the house refused to let him in. Shortly afterwards, a second gang member dressed as a postman knocked at the door and produced a handgun. Once inside, the maid and a window cleaner were handcuffed together. 42-year-old Pat Lancaster arrived later, and she too was handcuffed by the gang, armed with guns, knives and bottles of petrol. The gang intended to hold her hostage until her husband Victor arrived with what they thought would be thousands of pounds in wages from his office cleaning business.
The most frightening thing was them waiting for my husband to come home, because they had petrol, or they had something on their hands, because I could smell it. And, you know, it was just that I didn't want him to come home, because I think that they would have killed him.
Ironically, only 50 yards from the house, armed flying squad officers were keeping watch on the gang's two stolen getaway cars after a tip-off from a suspicious member of the public. However, the gang were monitoring the police radio and panicked. They abandoned an attempt to get away in the Lancaster's Rolls-Royce after dragging a safe to the car. Instead, they fled in a red Ford Turbo belonging to the Lancaster son. The car, registration number E919EGY, is still missing, along with £2,500 in cash and two £9,000 Rolex watches from the house. The police were unaware of the hostage drama.
The people were already in situ inside the house before flying squad officers were anywhere near the scene. They also had a monitoring device where they were monitoring radio signals, and I believe they also had a man on foot outside the premises with a walkie-talkie radio, giving details of what was happening outside the premises. We had the situation in control as we saw it, but unfortunately they were in the house at the time, which was unbeknown to anybody, and were monitoring our signals.
Pat Lancaster's ordeal has left her husband furious.
My feelings, I'd like to see him and smash him, wouldn't I? You know, obviously, I feel very bitter for what they've done.
Police have issued three photo-fit pictures of some of the gang. They think between five or six people were involved. Police are convinced they're dealing with a gang of hardened South London criminals. Their men are highly organised, but also armed and dangerous and prepared to use force. Officers stress that under no circumstances should they be approached. This is Ken Andrew in Orpington for Thames News.